Hello, my dear students. How are you? Hope you are fine and same is the case with your host and teacher. Just before you, Mr. Mohan sir, Pidgin English. Okay, my dear, today I have opted to go for narration. As you know, the topic of tense has been completed to some extent. And anyways, if you do get any more feedback from me, if you require any more thing to be delivered on it, you will give me feedback regarding it in the way you like, either in my inbox or either by any sort of technical way you think it feasible. Okay, dear students. So today's topic we are going to discuss here is narration. As I would like to remind those very brothers and sisters of mine who are going to participate in JKSSB exams and any other competitive exam, and the syllabus there prescribed is like we see there the very first topic is their tenses and then it is narration. Okay, so I have opted to go for narration this time because this is a lengthy topic and it takes a lot of time to complete if we go in detail, but I'm going to cut it short and I'm going to put it technically here so that you may be comprehend easily, so that you are in a position to do on your own, so that you are in a position to attempt your on your own very easily and very precisely and especially more judiciously, so that your answers are correct when you are going to attempt your papers. Okay, my dear students, so let us go to the topic directly without delaying anymore. So far as the topic of narration is concerned, the concept of narration, in other words, we say it speech as well. And this narration is of two types. It means we narrate the things in two ways. One is direct and another is indirect. Bilwasta and bilawasta. In Urdu we say. Okay, dear. So, far as this direct narration is concerned, that its speech is concerned, we have two parts of it. See here, I have given here the diagram. One is reporting verb and next is reported speech. And so far as indirect is concerned, we have here various things that we need to remember, various alterations, changes and requirements. For instance, here in the first very box I have written removal of comma and inverted commas. Okay, next is use of pronouns. How to use pronouns when we are going to change direct narration into indirect narration. That is one more point, technical point. And then it is change of tenses. Then it is change of tenses. Okay, dear students. So, one by one I shall deal with all these things and try to make it more easier. And we say abridged sort of concept for you, so that you easily comprehend it and you are easily able to do on your own when you are attempting the question paper. I hope so, inshallah. Okay, dear students. So far as this direct speech or narration is concerned, I just want to give you an example here so that you understand it easily. The statement, the speech that is written in such a way where there is no modification on part of the person who is going to present it. For example, I am referring to the words by any third person here, but I don't mix it with my own words and I don't alter it, I don't give it, modify it as per my own feasibility. Then we say it is direct narration. Whatever has been said by any third person, any second person, oh, okay. So, we have a way, technical way, to put the things in commas and inverted commas. And this is the portion here, the first part, before this comma. Before this comma, that shows a pause. That shows a pause. He said, this is called here, this portion is here called reporting verb. Reporting verb means this is the part which reports the verb. Yani reporting verb ka matlab hai, which reports the verb. Okay, and this is reporting speech. Reporting speech. So So technically saying, this is the part which has been reported by the subject. Simple banane ke liye, to make it more simple. He said, yani usne kaha, what did he say? Kya kaha usne? I am writing a letter. So these are the actual words said by this third person singular he. And we don't modify it anyway. किसी भी तरीके से हम इसको मॉडिफाई नहीं करते हैं बिल्कुल भी टोटली वी पुट इट इन एक्चुअल मैनर अंडर कॉमास एंड इनवर्टेड कॉमास एंड विद प्रॉपर पंक्चुएशन द टेक्निकल पॉइंट द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर हियर दिस इज द वेरी कॉमा एंड आई शुड से ओनली कॉमा आफ्टर विच वी यूज कैपिटल लेटर्स अदरवाइज नो वेयर Capital letters are used after comma in normal situation. But in this direct narration, when it is going, when the reporting verb and reported speech are separated by a comma and the reported speech is put under commas and inverted commas, this is the place where we use capital letter after a comma. After a comma. Okay. Let us go ahead. So, this is called reporting verb and this is called reported speech. Let me repeat it again. Why this is called reporting verb? Because it reports. What is given in the reported speech? Okay, this is reported speech, and this is the speech that has been reported by this subject here. Okay, I think it is clear now, and we should now move towards the chain of this direct into indirect. That is actually going to be the point, but we need to understand. Okay, dear students. For the sake of making it more easy and more understandable, I have written here two sentences. One is, two statements of direct speech. One is, he said, I am writing a letter. And next is, he says, I am writing a letter. So, my dear students, my dear viewers, notice here, in this reporting world, this is said, that means past of say, or says, and this is says here, in the present of say, present of say. Okay, now the matter is, if we are going to change this one in indirect, it will be changed in this way. He said that he was going, he was writing a letter, and in the same way if I want to change this one, I will change this one by one. He says that he is writing a letter. Okay, dear students, you just notice the difference between these two changed versions, indirect versions. First one was, he said, I am writing a letter, and I converted it in this way. He said that he was writing a letter. Means I am writing, got changed into was writing. Precisely saying present continuous got changed into past continuous. I am not going to deal with the elaborate rules that are going to take enormous time. So we should be technical enough. हमें अब rules सीखने की मतलब ज़रूरत नहीं है. We are not going to face any academic examination, and especially if in case we are going to face the academic examination, so the best way I think is to understand in this way that I am going to show here. Okay, he said that he was writing a letter, and present continuous got changed into past continuous. I am writing equal to was writing. Okay, but in this sentence, he says that he is writing a letter. Here it was, I am writing a letter. What is the difference? Did any change take place? No change took place in case of tenses. Change of tense बिल्कुल भी हुआ नहीं, टोटली है nothing happened with regard to change of tense, but one thing happened, that is change of pronoun took place. I got changed into he. I got changed into he. Okay, dear. These are the things we have to clear, and our case is solved, and our issue is resolved about the rule of tenses. That this rule of narration change of narration from direct to indirect. So this is the thing that perplexes us every time during the examination, because we are given them multiple choice. हमारे पास चार options होते हैं. तो under the pressure है, sort of situation, we can't decide which is correct one. So if the things are clear in advance, at that time it will not create any problem for we people, and we shall be easily able to do it easily. तो हम आसानी से कर पाएंगे उस वक्त, you need not worry here. Okay, dear students. So far as this sentence is concerned, I changed it this way, and the only logic is that when this reporting verb is in past tense, you just remember it as, I'm not going to write it here. जब reporting verb past tense में है, तो जो आगे वाला reported speech है, तो its tense is changed into its corresponding tense. Means अगर यहाँ पे indefinite tense में exist होता है sentence statement, तो it will go and get changed into past simple. अगर या past indefinite. अगर ये continuous में है, तो ये past continuous में जाएगा. अगर ये प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट में है, तो ये प्रेजेंट पास्ट परफेक्ट में जाएगा. अगर ये प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस में है, तो ये प्रेजेंट पास्ट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस में जाएगा. अगर ये पास्ट इंडिफिनिट में है, तो ये पास्ट परफेक्ट में चला जाएगा. अगर ये पास्ट कंटिन्यूअस है, तो ये पास्ट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस में चला जाएगा. एंड लाइक वाइज देन देर आर टू टेंसेस, पास्ट परफेक्ट एंड पास्ट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस, दैट रिमेन अनचेंज्ड. These were the just rules of change we have to remember here. But as per my experience, we can't recollect all those rules, lengthy rules during the examination. Rather, we should have a technical sort of way to convert them quickly. Okay, so that is what I actually mean to share with you here, the things.